Well, friends, it's sadly come down to this, but I think it's the right decision to make. I am returning the Razer Book 13. Now, this particular model is the 16 gig i7 with a 256 SSD and just above full HD resolution, 1920 by 1200. It's beautiful. I love it. It's awesome, but it's not perfect. And it's not that I'm looking for perfect. I can live with certain flaws, or I can live with certain design choices. They're not flaws, right? They're just design choices. But I need a better keyboard, and that's really what it's come down to for me. So on the one hand, there is a defect issue that Razer's been helping me with that would ultimately result in an exchange, and that is that the right speaker makes a popping noise. Regardless of the volume level of the speakers, it will just make this popping noise. So that's obviously something I can't live with. And then also the keyboard. It's just too inconsistent in terms of key travel, and I'm having just a lot of trouble on the left side of the keyboard getting those keys to stick. So it might be me. And if it is, I know that I'll be more comfortable with another laptop. So the Razer Blade Stealth, I actually did buy one. I bought last year's model, and I had it for a brief period of time. I felt like the keyboard was more responsive to me. So I ordered the new 11th Gen i7 version of the Razer Blade Stealth. I'll get you guys a review on that one. I'd love to do a side-by-side with this beautiful Razer Book, but unfortunately, just the way that these two ships will pass in the night, they're not gonna be here with me at the same time. Now, if for some reason that changes, I'll go ahead and do a video on that. But I wanted to let you guys know, since so many of you watched the last video, that so many, you know, relative to how many normally watch my stuff, that this laptop it's very good. If you want something with pretty good battery life, but super thin and light and incredibly consistent in terms of how responsive the CPU is, it's very powerful for a thin and light, I think that you would like this a lot. $1,600 for this spec, totally worth it. In fact, I'm so impressed with how this i7-16 combo performed, I might suggest you try the $1,200 i5-8. It might be worth it, it really might. If you watch my videos, you know I never say that 8 gigs of RAM is enough for Windows. Some people do. I don't. I've done it enough times. I'm like, this is so bad. But you know, with the CPUs, these 11th gen CPUs are so powerful that it might be the case. Now, I'm not the kind of reviewer that can dig into all the details and tell you why or what and how, but I can tell you just sort of anecdotally as an end user that this is so good that even if you clock it down 20%, it's still going to be pretty awesome. So might be worth a shot. Okay, so enough endorsement of that. But the big advantage that this thing has over the Razer Blade Stealth is the 16:10 aspect ratio. For me, as a productivity person. So I have a gaming laptop and it's super powerful. I don't think I'm going to end up using the Razer Blade Stealth for gaming, but maybe I will. I don't know. Maybe I will once I have it. So I'm gonna check it out and put it through its paces and show it to you guys. So That's the deal. That's the story. So a slight defect on this. I would have done an exchange, but Microsoft's actually been kind of mean. So I'm the Microsoft store, so I'm not going to go into those details. But long story short, the fact that this listing is now correct on the Microsoft store is because I told them to fix it 3 times, and they finally fixed it twice until they got it right. And it's still not entirely right, but it's close enough. So anyway, that's a long story. I don't want to go into it. So yeah, that's the deal. Returning it, gonna try the Stealth. I'll let you guys know when I do that. Cheers.